Acute promyelocytic leukemia is a rare type of leukemia.
APL is a bit of a confusing condition for anybody, including patients and their family, and sometimes for some of the medical staff working with them, because it's a bit different than other types of leukemia.
Recent discoveries have shown that the management of these patients can lead to excellent results. The key in survival is the early start of treatment with a drug called Atra, which has revolutionized the treatment of this disease.
Many years ago, it used to be recognized as the worst form of acute leukemia.
From 10 to 40% of the patients would die from the disease.
Almost all the deaths happened within the first 10 to 14 days because of the massive problems that could happen with the bleeding that we could not really control very well, or serious infections that they had before they were diagnosed with the leukemia.
It used to be one of the most fatal types of acute myeloid leukemia, while today actually it's one of the most curable types of leukemia, both in adults and in children.
My name is Dr. Brian Lieber. I'm a hematologist at the Jervinsky Cancer Center and Hospital, and I treat patients with all kinds of leukemia, including acute promyelocytic leukemia. I've been working with leukemia patients for almost 30 years.
I'm Dr. Osama Abla, a staff pediatric oncologist at the Hospital for the Children, and I've been working as a leukemia specialist in the last 17 years. My main interest is in acute promyelocytic leukemia in children. Acute promyelocytic leukemia, or APL, is a rare subtype of acute myeloid leukemia, which can happen both in children and in adults. It's a cancer of the white blood cells.
And like all leukemias, it's an increase in the number of immature cells in the bone marrow. Therefore, the normal function of the bone marrow is compromised.
The bone marrow is a soft, spongy tissue inside of our bones. That is basically the factory of the blood cells. White blood cells are designed to move into the bloodstream to fight infections. Red blood cells circulate oxygen in the body. And blood platelets act usually as internal band-aids, creating blood clots when the body is injured. In the normal bone marrow, white blood cells form and grow in stages. But acute promyelocytic leukemia blocks the cell's growth at an early stage, the promyelocyte stage.
Promyelocytes are like adolescents. They're halfway between starting and being where they should be. Like adolescents, they sometimes do things they shouldn't do, but if they do it for short periods of time, that's okay. If you have too many adolescents built up at once in the world and there's no adults to supervise them, well, it won't take long for things to go amiss.
These promyelocytes become overproduced, making the patient prone to infection, increasing their white blood cell count. They also prevent the production of red blood cells, which makes patients anemic and tired because there is less blood to carry oxygen around the body. And when these cells crowd the bone marrow, blood platelets begin to diminish, and patients may bleed and bruise more easily.
The promyelocytic leukemia cells themselves suck up coagulation factors that help the platelets function. So if you want, it's a double whammy.
The cause of APL is unknown, but what we know is that there is an abnormal swapping of two chromosomes inside of the cells.
The human body is made up of cells that grow and divide to make new cells. This allows the body to grow and heal. When a cell divides into two new cells, the cell information is duplicated, one for each new cell. This information includes its genes, which are contained in packages called chromosomes. Chromosomes contain long strands of DNA, the genetic information that tells each cell what to do, and there are 23 pair of them in each cell.
Sometimes when a cell divides, chromosome information can get lost or mixed up. Most of the time, this isn't a problem.
Normally in our body, mutations are repaired. All it takes is that one rare event for one particular type of mutation not to be repaired, where two chromosomes who normally should be separate get swapped. And that happens in a way that is very difficult to predict in the general population.
In patients with APL, some of the gene information in chromosomes 15 and 17 is swapped, creating a fusion protein called PML RARA. This misinformation will send the wrong message to the cells, and since cells only do what their DNA tells them to do, the APL cells actually do not perform properly.
So APL really happens out of the blue. Unlike many other types of cancers, there probably isn't anything that people did wrong in their lifestyle. In other words, smoking, which is associated with a lot of other cancers, probably does not predispose you to getting APL. APL can happen throughout life. Unlike other types of leukemia, it may be slightly less frequent in older individuals, but it can happen really to anybody at any age. In a large city like Toronto, for example, there might be about 10 or 15 APL patients in a year total of all ages. A certain proportion of those are going to be adults, and a smaller proportion will be children under the age of 18. So you can see it is quite rare, and therefore it's important that people and doctors recognize the early symptoms quickly, because it can be quite dangerous, especially at the early stages when you need to reverse the problem with the blood coagulation.
The good news is that today we know how to treat it.
So when you have decreased bone marrow function, your red blood cells go down and people are more tired. When your white blood cells go down, you're more susceptible to infection. So sometimes the first time a patient knows they have leukemia is they have maybe a cold that doesn't go away, or perhaps a more serious infection.
Also fever.
The third blood cell type that we talked about is the platelet that helps with blood coagulation. And when it is decreased, people have more bleeding, and it can be anywhere.
Bruising on their muscles or skin or even joints. The joints can be painful as well. But most commonly it happens on the skin and the surface of the muscles.
A bruise that's bigger than you would have expected, a little cut, a paper cut that bleeds more than it should.
And sometimes massive bleeding from the nose.
In young women, it can be menstruation that doesn't stop when it should.
Unusual for them, that would cause them to feel very sick.
Things that you wouldn't normally expect to have bleed, like internal bleeding from the stomach, where you might either throw up blood or have dark stools.
Or even bleeding in the lungs. Sometimes there would be other symptoms like bone pain.
And most seriously, perhaps, bleeding inside the head that would present sometimes with great fatigue or confusion or headache or decreased vision. Any combination of these symptoms might be caused by bleeding in the head.
Thrombosis is when you have clotting of blood in the vessels. When the blood is not circulating in the vessel, especially the vessels of the brain, then the patient can actually develop a stroke. A clot can happen anywhere in the body. It can happen also in the lungs and in other areas. But when it happens in the brain, it can be fatal if not treated aggressively. And sometimes even with treatment, it can be difficult to reverse. That's the specific feature of APL, is that patients can have both bleeding and clotting at the same time. And sometimes these two can be coexisting in the brain. And those are the patients that are the most difficult to treat. And that's where we have high incidence of early death, is when there is cerebral bleeding and thrombosis at the same time.
Suspecting leukemia is based upon people presenting with the symptoms of the blood cells being down, people being tired, more prone to infections or having an infection, and problems with bleeding.
The first test is to look at the blood film on the microscope.
Blood counts being down is something that can be recognized on a very simple blood test that can be done in any emergency room or through any doctor's office.
In most centers, the results of this blood test would take from 30 to 45 minutes to come out.
That gives you the suspicion that there's something wrong with the bone marrow. There are many other reasons why blood cells can be decreased, but leukemia clearly is one of them, perhaps not the most common, but a serious one that you don't want to miss.
APL is usually diagnosed when we see these abnormal promyelocytes in large numbers. And it should be treated immediately at the first suspicion of the disease.
Knowing the test is positive, we would go ahead and treat with blood transfusions to prevent blood bleeding problems as soon as we know that, even before we have the confirmation by the bone marrow. Now with this test, we can find out much more quickly and treat as quickly as we can.
This is followed usually by a confirmatory test that we do in the bone marrow and in the blood. These patients will have to undergo bone marrow aspirate, which is a procedure that will involve them being sedated, involve inserting a needle into the bone of their hip, and bone marrow is taken from their hip and will be analyzed in the lab.
You really need a bone marrow test to confirm the fact that this decrease in blood counts is caused by leukemia.
In the lab, they do different tests on the bone marrow. First of one called morphology, which means they look at the shape of the cells on the microscope to determine that these are indeed APL cells. They are usually recognized easily by an experienced hematologist or hematopathologist.
Acute promyelocytic leukemia, or APL, is a subtype that has a very specific genetic mutation that causes it.
The PML RARA gene that you can actually detect with different tests. Through genetics, we do the FISH analysis, which confirms the translocation between chromosome 15 and 17. Through the molecular testing, we do the PCR, which is the most sophisticated test, which confirms the presence of this fusion gene, the PML RARA. Both of these tests are very specific for APL. Flow cytometry is an additional test that is done on the bone marrow cells, which looks at the markers at the surface of the APL cells. Once these tests are confirmed, then the diagnosis of APL is usually confirmed 100%. APL can be classified into high risk and standard risk. Patients with a white blood cell count of more than 10,000 are considered high risk with an increased risk of early complications. Standard risk APL are those patients that present with a white blood cell count in the blood of less than 10,000. The disease in the beginning can be quite aggressive and can be fatal if not treated immediately. Parents usually will accept the immediate interventions of the medical team promptly with no hesitations, because other solutions are non-existing, and if not treated, this disease is fatal.
If you can get past that stage, the survival is probably greater than 95 and maybe even greater than 98%. This is certainly better than any other type of leukemia and probably better than any other type of cancer. So the prognosis, if you can get by the first storm in the first 2 weeks of bleeding and lesser infection, then the prognosis is quite good with the two new developments that have been recognized over the last 15 years.